We showed how to use 3D text inside of After Effects, but you can take 3D much further and create something like this. Again, all inside of After Effects by using, you guessed it, After Effects. First, we need our 3D model. There's a ton of free and paid sites like CG Trader, Turbo Squid, and Sketchfab. Of course, the cheaper the model, the chances are the less detail they're going to have. So keep budget in mind when planning. Ideally, it's good to know what 3D model you'll be using before you even shoot, since you can adjust your plan to fit the model that you have. Today, we're gonna start with this UFO model right here. Inside of After Effects, we can import a GLB, GLTF, or OBJ file. However, there is a chance that the model you downloaded is an FBX file, and if that's the case, you won't be able to import that into After Effects. To solve this issue, it's best to download the Blender software, which is free 3D software, and export out an animated OBJ sequence. I'm not going to get into how to do that here, but there are plenty of videos on YouTube to walk you through that. Now, with our model imported into After Effects, we want to access any animations that may come with the file. So if you open the drop-down menu, there may be an Animation Options tab that allows you to view and adjust the duration of different animations. If you don't see that option and want to animate your 3D model, a great site to use is Adobe's Mixamo, which will allow you to rig and animate your 3D model using various pre-made animations. We've used it a ton and abused it plenty. I've been running, keep up, gunning, stop the frame on your word. It's what you hear, not what you heard. I'ma hang on every verb. They also have their own 3D characters you can download, with the only thing to keep in mind is that you'll have to download it as an FBX file and convert that in Blender. But with our file ready, the next step is to compose the 3D model into our footage. With our background footage in a new comp, we can simply drop in our GLB file, prompting these messages, which we'll just tap OK. Now we can easily move the position and rotation how we like in the scene. To help it fit better into the environment, we're going to use an HDRI, which stands for High Dynamic Range Imaging, and is especially useful for something reflective like our UFO. So we hunted down an HDRI of a similar environment to the background plate, then we'll place it in the comp and hide visibility. To use it for our 3D model, we'll create an environment light, then choose our HDRI layer as the source. This also works with the rotation and intensity values to help you fine-tune the look. So we'll rotate it until the sun is coming from our screen right, like our footage, and since this footage has some motion, we can get a quick 3D camera track, and after we do that and create a null and camera, our UFO updates automatically. If you want to add any effects to this 3D object, just pre-compose with any lights, HDRIs, or nulls being used, and you can then apply effects to this layer, like changing color and adding blur or glow to the highlights. Lastly, we can add a couple keyframes for position and rotation, giving us this. You can also use 3D models with built-in animations like we talked about before, like this frog model here, which looks like the exact same model we used for a project we did with Adobe back in 2013.
I am talking about love.
Yeah, okay.
But once again, we convert if needed and drop the model into our comp, this time choosing an animation preset from this dropdown. Then we'll use an HDRI again with an environment light. We can also use other types of light to add extra highlights and details, like faking some green bounce from this area here. Now we'll add a shadow by creating a solid layer, making it 3D, and placing it beneath our frog. The environment light already has cast shadows enabled, so we'll see the shadow right away. And in the solid layer setting, we can change the shadow color, and we'll set the solid setting to accept shadows only. Then in the environment light, we can change shadow darkness, and in the advanced 3D render options, you can increase things like quality and smoothness to refine. If we look here, we do have some shallow depth of field that we'll want to match. To do that, we'll pre-compose all these layers, and on a duplicate, we'll use the 3D channel extract effect, dialing in the values to get a nice depth contrast. Then on our other frog layer with the camera lens blur effect, choose the depth duplicate and change to use effects and masks. Now, increase the blur radius and change the focal distance to select which section of the frog we want to be in focus, before dialing the radius back down to match our scene. Then, with a few more effects to finish off our composite, we have this. So as you can see, there's so much that you can do with 3D inside of After Effects. This is, of course, just a quick overview to get you started, but you can take it really far, especially with additional plugins like Element 3D. Using nothing but After Effects, my VFX artist Ryan Thompson has been able to craft some really impressive shots, again, without ever leaving After Effects. As always, if you have any questions or want to suggest something that you'd like to see us cover, let us know in the comments below. And subscribe to the channel for more tutorials and updates like this one, because ants don't have lungs. Did you know that?